thank you very much. I'm very pleased to be here today to represent the OCB working group and to give you an update. So first of all, I would like to go back to the recommendations that were formulated last year at the last annual meeting. So there were a lot of recommendations concerning the implementation of the preventive campaigns to have more preventive campaigns implemented and campaigns aligned with the hotspot mapping and to have criteria for OCV prioritization. To continue close engagement with Gavi, to have the collaboration with the CSP in terms of developing requests for OCV implementation and monitoring and evaluation for campaigns. To have a collaboration with the other working groups, such as the surveillance working group for hotspot mapping and the WASH working group for implementation of WASH activities during the campaigns. So in terms of key achievements, many doses were shipped to countries since the creation of the stockpile in 2013. It's more than 87 million doses that were shipped to countries. The shipments were multiplied by 100 in 7 years. In 2020, 2.1 million doses were shipped. And despite this crisis, there was a big effort and from the manufacturers to keep ongoing on the production in order to provide the doses to the outbreaks and the preventive campaigns. 50% of the doses shipped were for preventive campaigns. So in 2021, we had 6.4 million doses that were approved for ICG requests. We only had ICG requests this year, but already 13.5 million doses were shipped, and compared to last year where it was 12.8 million. As you can see in the graph, the campaign that were implemented this year were mainly for preventive campaign in DRC, Uganda, Zambia, and soon in Zanzibar. This year, we implemented the campaigns were implemented in 8 countries, soon 9 in Zanzibar with the support of Gavi. In Sudan and Cameroon, there were co-vaccination in refugee camps, in IDP camps. So in Sudan, there was a vaccination of OCV and yellow fever implemented. And in Cameroon, in the East region, co-vaccination of OCV plus polio. It's very important because it was a strong recommendation that was done in each OCV working group the former year. Something that we wanted also to improve was in the monitoring and evaluation was the coverage surveys. There was a lack of implementation of coverage surveys after campaigns. And this year, more coverage surveys were implemented or will be implemented with strong protocol, including also WASH assessments in the questionnaires. So that was the case in DRC with the support of GHU. There will be soon a coverage survey in Zanzibar with the support of CDC. So there are more efforts on implementing coverage survey. Last year, the OCV working group and the WASH working group developed a minimum package of WASH activities to implement during emergency campaigns. And it will be, this guidance will be piloted, implemented in the campaign in Ethiopia that will start soon in the Tigray region. For the CSP, there was a The first deployment started in Zanzibar and Mozambique, and it was a very good experience for us to work together on how we will better implement the campaigns. The impact studies were and are still implemented in DRC with the support of Johns Hopkins University, Epicentre, and University of Florida. This year, many countries had identified their hotspots, and we are receiving some draft of GTFCC requests aligned with the identification of those hotspots. That's the case, for example, for Ethiopia, Yemen, that are really working on GTFCC requests based on the identification of the hotspot. Other countries, such as Cameroon, Mozambique, Nigeria, and Togo, are preparing also hotspot identification, and it will really help to start to work on further GTFCC requests. This year, we also developed a database of the vaccination by district to know the number of doses and the year of each vaccination campaign that were implemented by district. And we are working on the country profile with the GHU to have a country profile for OCV. We also have finished to develop a job aid of vaccination during COVID that was really requested by countries. We started to implement every 2 months a meeting with the OCV working group in order to speak about, to give an update on the campaigns, to see the challenges, to discuss on the hotspots, but also to have an update on the research, where are the partners in terms of research and studies that are implemented. So in terms of challenges, there are some challenges always linked, still linked with COVID-19, but it's better. True that there were a lot of staff that were repurposed to COVID, and it was sometimes difficult to implement some campaigns, some postponing of campaigns because of the COVID, and still some restriction on the travel. Even now, if we are more allowed to travel, it's still difficult to send some staff. The other challenge are regarding the supply and the demands. As the previous years, the demand is still sometimes aligned to the supply. When the countries want to apply to get access to the stockpile, the first question is how many doses can I have? So that is still something that we always wanted to improve. We are still working on, and there's a work that's still in progress regarding the guidance of the hotspot prioritization for OCV. There will be some work group that will be implemented this year in order to work on that. Some studies are still difficult to implement and to continue the studies this year. As I said, for the moment, we don't have, there is still a progress in having GTFCC requests, preventive requests, but it's linked also to the hotspot mapping that is taking time. But we have some draft already and some countries that will submit soon. Concerning the chair of the OCV working group, for the moment, there's no chair that is identified. For personal reason, the former chair had to leave, but we are working on that to identify someone as soon as possible and to continue those meetings every 2 months. The quality of the request is still challenging. We are still receiving some requests that are not that we cannot always submit, and we still need to provide guidance to countries to receive better requests. There are some countries where the insecurity issues are difficult to implement some campaigns. They are delaying the implementations of the campaigns. And we still need the collaboration with the EPI programs. So with the OCV working group, we had identified the priorities for 2021-2022. And we decided to focus on the deployment of some countries. Priority will be done on some countries this year: Nigeria, Ethiopia, we started already, Sudan, Mozambique, and Bangladesh. We plan to develop and to work with the CSP on a training package for consultants to be deployed in order to better have people that can implement, that can develop requests and monitoring and evaluations for the campaigns. Some technical documents will be also developed for the MOH of in endemic countries to help them on how to make a request, how to access to the stockpile, how to prepare and organize campaigns, and how to develop monitoring and evaluation after those campaigns. So we plan to implement that. Of course, the prioritization for OCV hotspot is one of the priority of this year, and to continue the work that was done in common with the surveillance working group. And we plan to expand also the composition of the working group and to include more people by this year. So top five of research priorities were identified. The first is concerning the optimal OCV schedule, especially in terms of number of doses and dosing interval. Some studies were done in Cameroon. The second is the delivery strategy in hard-reach population. The vaccination also in some community, the optimal number of doses to be used in follow-up of campaigns in community previously vaccinated. The impact of the OCV in targeting specific populations and the impact of timing of OCV use on prevention of outbreak. We would like really to thank all the members of the OCV working group that are providing their expertise on everything, on the request, on the studies, on everything, and that are always supporting the countries for implementation of the vaccinations. Thank you.